Hello friends and my dear students, as we have discussed about the designing of worm gear, so today from the book of machine design by R.S. Khurmi and J.K. Gupta, we are referring one example or numerical which has been asked in various university exams. So you can also practice such kind of numericals from different textbooks. Okay, so this is there in the chapter number 31. If you will see that the design 20 degree involute worm and gear means worm wheel and gear drive to transmit 10 kilowatt power with the worm rotating at a 1400 rpm and to obtain a speed reduction of 12:1. The distance between the shaft is 2 to 5 mm. So only these things are given and you have to calculate means design this particular worm gear drive. So given is pressure angle is given, 20 degree, power is given, and n, because this is a different book which we are referring during the lecture, that was B.B. Bhandari and it is R.S. Khurmi and Gupta book. So some notations will be different. Okay, so the speed of worm is 1400 rpm, velocity ratio is 12, and x, which is the distance between the shaft, is 2 to 5 mm. Now as you know that the distance between the two worm and worm wheel is x. Okay, so this x value is given as 2 to 5 and you have to calculate the value of ln, okay, for the calculation of axial lead. So before that you have to calculate the value of lambda. Okay, so the value of lambda will be cot cube gamma, which is equals to velocity ratio. With the help of that you can calculate the value of lambda. Then you can easily calculate the value of ln with the help of this center distance formula. If you will keep all these values, then move to the axial lead, which is ln divided by cos lambda. Now we find out that velocity ratio is of 12, the number of starts of the thread will be 4, and the axial pitch will be L by 4, and module will be PA by pi. Okay, axial pitch divided by pi. So in this way we are able to calculate the value of module and axial pitch. Then axial pitch of the threads of the worm will be pi m, which will be your one calculation is done. Then axial lead of the threads on the worm will be equals to PA into N, number of turns, that will be equals to this much. Then you can calculate the value of normal lead of the threads on the worm. Okay, then move towards the value of X, which is the center distance. This we are getting it as 230 here. Now if you will move and calculate the value of face length of the worm or the length of the threaded portion, all these formulas you can get it with the help of your design data book. So refer that particular book. So these are the few notations, like H, addendum and dedendum, you have calculated outer diameter, you have calculated. So these are the formulas which will be given in your design data book. You can refer those and calculate it directly. After that you can calculate the design for the worm gear, means pitch circle diameter of worm gear, then outside diameter of the worm gear. So these are the formulas. M into TG will be the value of pitch circle diameter of worm gear. Similarly you can calculate the face bit, throat diameter, and other values or other calculations related to the worm gear or worm wheel. Okay, now you have to calculate that it is able to transmit the such tangential load or not. So for that you can apply the principle of power and speed relation. Okay, so with the help of power and speed relation you can calculate the value of your tangential load. So the tangential load acting on the gear will be 2 into torque divided by dg. Torque you have already calculated with the help of power and speed. Okay, power is equals to 2 pi nt by 60. Okay, with the help of that you have calculated the value of torque. Then you can calculate the value of tangential load. After calculation of tangential load you can also calculate the value of pitch line velocity, which is pi dn divided by 60. On the basis of v, the formula for the worm gear is 6 by 6 plus v. So this will give you the value of velocity factor. Now if you will calculate the value of your Lewis form factor on the basis of velocity factor and your pitch line velocity, then your Lewis form factor will come as 0.135. then since the worm gear is made up of phosphorus bronze and taking the allowable tensile static stress, that is already given in your design data book, depends on the material, sigma static will be equals to this much of value. Then you can calculate the value of design tangential load. Okay, this is this much. So this is more than the tangential load acting on the gear, therefore the design is safe from the from tangential load point of view. Similarly, you can also calculate the same thing with the help of dynamic load. Okay, so for the dynamic load calculation, what you have to do, you have to divide tangential load divided by your velocity factor. This is, in this way you can calculate this value. Then check the for the static load or endurance strength, which is 168. Now you can calculate the static load or endurance strength on the basis of this particular limit value according to the material you have selected. Since this is much more than this value, which is 4260, and this you have calculating here as 33635, means this much of tangential load it can sustain, but it is quite more than that. So similarly, this is also safe from the point of view of endurance strength. Similarly, you can check for the wear, okay, and check for the heat dissipation. Okay, I'm just scrolling it. You can go through it and prepare. I will cover this particular whole numerical in the next session, remaining one. Okay, so meanwhile, stay tuned with Engineering College Banswara YouTube channel for more such updates about different branches of engineering like mechanical, electrical, civil, and computer science engineering. Thank you so much.